Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss radical polymerization, which is the most common method for making addition polymers from alkene monomers. As with all these alkene polymerizations, we're starting with an alkene monomer. In this case, the initiator is not a nucleophile, as in an anionic polymerization. The initiator is not an acid, as in a cationic polymerization. Instead, the initiator is a radical source, something like N-bromocyanamide, also called NBS, with light, forms a low concentration of bromine radicals, Br dot. The initiator adds to the alkene to form a new carbon radical. Note that with radical mechanisms, we move electrons one at a time with fishhook arrows. The new radical can react with another alkene, the monomer, this will form another radical intermediate. This process can continue until eventually we get a new addition polymer. I've drawn the repeat unit, and notice that the atoms in the repeat unit are the exact same as what we saw in our original monomer. What kind of R group stabilizes a radical? Well, just about any R group makes a radical more stable. So our R group can be an EWG, because EWGs stabilize radicals. It can be an electron donating group, an EDG, because EDGs stabilize radicals. The fact is, radical polymerizations are very flexible reactions and are actually more common than either anionic or cationic addition polymerizations. Radicals perform addition reactions that can form polymers. The reaction is very general and often works better than either anionic or cationic addition polymerizations.